Super Draco 380 here, and we're back for stage two of the Bismarck, the foremost 38 centimeter gun turret. So to begin with, this pack is continuing where we left off, and instead of showing you the parts, I'm just going to jump right into the build. So first things first, we have the armored hood for the gun turret. And what we're going to be doing is, first off, we're going to be attaching these two details on this sprue. These are called ventilators. They're extremely small, so just like before, I'm going to line up my sprue cutter and then grab the part, make sure it doesn't go flying off. And going to rinse and repeat with the second one. And get the sprue out of the way and just set the part right there. So just like before, we're going to be gluing those into place. First, I'm going to get the part and I want to see how it fits into the gun turret, or the armored hood for the gun turret, I should say. I'm just checking the instructions. So that peg is going to go into that slot on the gun turret, on the hood. And so here we have the armored hood. As you can see, I found the ventilator and attached it in place, just gluing it in using a toothpick to apply the glue, just like I was in the step before. So here we are, I'm attaching the ventilator into place, just making sure it's fitting flush. And a little thumbs up just to show that I got it. And I'm in no way frustrated or upset after having to look for it for so long. So then I'm checking the instructions. Next up, these little ladders are going to attach to the sides. They're extremely hard to grab. They are made out of metal. So gotta be careful so we don't accidentally bend them or the pegs. As we can see, I'm just gonna use my tweezers to get them out because my hands are just too big. So I'm verifying, and just look how tiny that ladder is. The camera doesn't even want to focus on it, but do you see those little tiny pegs? What we're going to do is I'm going to use my toothpick, apply some glue to those little pegs, and it's just going to attach to the sides of the armored hood. I'm just going to use my tweezers so I can try to line it up. First two holes in. Just going to make sure it's all the way in. Don't want to press too hard and bend the metal pegs. And that's one ladder. And we're going to just do the same thing to the other side. Just loading up my toothpick with a little bit more super glue. And we're just going to dab that onto each of the four pegs. Just like that, there are the ladders. So then the next thing we're going to work on is I check my instructions. We're going to be building the friction clutch. First up, we're going to take the two gun barrels. The gun barrels are metal and they're going to attach to the connector. to apply some super glue to the peg at the bottom of the gun barrel. Now I'm just trying to see, I'm verifying the instructions because there's a hole on it. I just want to verify that it doesn't go in a specific orientation. Now my test fit of it, I only put a small dab of glue on there. And as I can see, it's not holding in very well at all. Now it's holding in much better on the other side. So first off, making sure it's nice and straight. So then I'm going to take the second one, and I'm going to apply a more liberal amount of glue to it, just because the first one didn't want to fit in there very well. And I'm just taking the first one out, and just going to add much more glue to it, just so it'll stay a lot better. As with those being metal, my big concern is when the gun elevates and elevates that the barrels might come loose. Next, we're going to bring in the ring and we're going to fit that onto the connector with the clutch shaft. The instructions are highly specific. Do not glue any of these. So you can see it is shaped to fit, so it's pretty simple to figure out if you've got in the right orientation or not. And then the shape of that is going to match the shape of the ring, and it should fit in there. It's not glued, so it's going to be a little bit loose. So next I'm going to need the tension spring. And the spring is just going to fit right there. Now I'm going to hold the spring so it doesn't launch off or fall off on its own. And you notice I've got my middle finger holding the ring on as well. So then this is just going to slide into the cradle with base plate. Very careful, make sure the shaft goes all the way through like that, and that the spring pushes it back. And I'm just checking my instructions, verifying that I'm doing everything as intended. And now that that's in place, next I need the upper part of the motor mount. So after I make sure I've got it oriented properly, then I'm going to need these PB screws. As you can see, I'm using my opener. I'm just going to get a couple of screws. And I'm just looking for my screwdriver. I've got a magnetized screwdriver, and of course this is out of frame. There we go. And all I'm going to do is take two PB screws provided in kit and just screw it in. Now you don't want to over tighten these because you don't want to stress the plastic or strip the head of the screw. Getting a little resistance. I was considering getting some oil for this, but ultimately I managed to get enough leverage to get them in properly without damaging anything. And as you can see, I'm just testing the spring to make sure that the gun's reciprocating action is working as intended. So we're just checking the instructions, because next we're going to be mounting a motor. And we want to make sure we have the motor in the right orientation. So then, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the barrels forward a little bit and get that motor in place. And the motor, it has the same cross shape as the shaft inside there, so we just get them lined up and they're going to lock together nice and tight like that. And then we're going to put the lower motor mount on top of it, because right now the piece is actually upside down. And then we're going to secure that with two more PB screws. I prefer to use a magnetized screwdriver just so I don't have to worry about losing the screws as much as a non-magnetized. And we just repeat that on the other side. Next, I'm just finishing getting the second screw in. And checking, make sure it's still reciprocating as it should. I believe that is called reciprocating. Could be wrong. Feel free to correct me. I'm just checking the instructions again, because now we're going to take the housing and we're going to be fitting the gun barrel assembly inside of it. Now you see the barrels will just slide in like so, and then there's two pegs, and those you want to make sure those are fitted up into those two notches. So then we're going to take the turret base plate, and that is going to attach to the bottom of the turret with six more PB screws. There we should have it. So now we're just going to take a quick look, and the Anton gun should be complete. As we can see, the barrels are going to be moving up and down, and we can see the reciprocating action to simulate them firing. And with that complete, that is stage two complete. So we will be back for stage three, where we will be building the onboard aircraft Arado AR-196. I hope you enjoyed, and If you have any comments or suggestions, please don't hesitate to put them in the comments.